What's up, guys, and good morning, and welcome back to another week, another One Piece chapter. Today we're going to be reading One Piece chapter 861 from our manga stream. The title is The Consummate Actor. Okay, so consummate means when you have like intimacy to make a relationship final. So I'm guessing they're probably going to kiss. It's probably going to be about the wedding. All right, let's get into it. Page one, the consummate actor. Cat Viper on the front with more cats. Whoa. Okay. Page two. All right. Chapter start. At the top of the staircase of Candy Lies. It's a huge staircase. See the kids down there? That staircase is huge. I'm guessing at the top is where they're going to have the wedding on the roof. Whole Cake Chateau roof. Okay. Holy crap. All right, so we got the Nero Nero guy. Vito. Vito, what are you doing? So it's the door. Father, this is unbelievable. Just now, the president of the World Economic Times and the head of the Germer were talking. Riro. Of course they'll talk. They've got ears and mouth of their heads, haven't they? Well, all I know is that this party's on a completely different level. And he is scared. He has right to be. Capone look a little shooken too. Okay, the eldest son of Big Mom. I wonder, like, what is his fighting capabilities? Or is he just the eldest son? And the minister of candy, Pure Sparrow. And the eldest daughter, the minister of fruits, Compote. Okay, so this is the first time we saw her. She looks just like Big Mom, too. The second son commander, Dogtooth. Here we go with the epic art. The 14th daughter commander, Smoothie. The third son, Daifuku. And the fourth son, Oven. I can barely keep track of the number of monsters here. Meanwhile, Smoothie is just ringing out the lady that stabbed 100 man. And Dogtooth is like he's eating an apple or something. Just chilling. I mean, it was nice having these guys on our side, reassuring even. But just thinking about making enemies out of all of them sends shivers down my spine. Reroll. Stat. Enemies. Step, Big Mom. Ah, here come Caramel. Mama, please. Ooh, it's Mother Caramel. Why she look like she from the Kamabaka Kingdom? And she smokes with cigarettes. Indeed, our mother. Ah, I'm so glad to see Mother smiling so brightly today. I still don't even know who she is, but... Ha ha ha, mama, mama, mama. Yes, mother is the light of this world. Okay. I knew this was going to happen. This is the first time at one of your tea parties, so I was just wondering, how exactly is this person related to you, Big Mom? I knew someone was going to try her. Do not presume to trespass upon my memories. And he's fizzing. What did she do? Foaming at the mouth. Now, leave all that alone. Look, we've bought you presents, Charlotte, and some for your daughter in honor of her wedding day. Okay, so we're on page 7. Oh, treasure chest, my favorite. What is inside? What is hiding inside, I wonder? I brought some too, Linlin. Okay, so it's the Stussy girl, queen of the pleasure house, I think. Please, accept mine as well. Mine are rare gifts from the south. I have shipped my own as well, from the furthest reaches of the north. I'm positively elated. Thank you. Thank you for all this. Thank you indeed. I'm so happy. That's how Luffy would be if someone brought him meat from all over the world. All right. Speaking of treasure chests, I heard you recently obtained the great treasure of the seafloor recently. Ha. Someone, they try and Big Mom this chapter. This chapter. Oh, news does reach your ears quite quickly, Morgan. Indeed, I did. The treasure chest passed down in the royal lineage of the deep from generation to generation. And for some reason, I cannot fathom Neptune has willingly parted with it. And now it rests here with me. This is the treasure chest of legends itself. The Tamate Baku. Everyone's stunned. Ooh, world gravities. What presents? I wonder what in the world is inside. Huh? Along with all the other presents I have received, I will open this during the grand banquet after pudding ceremony. You will all get to see what is inside. I can't wait. After that ceremony, everybody will be dead, so it will be a sight indeed for those who are left to see what's inside. All right, page 9. Father, oh, done already? The preliminary preparations went off without a hitch. Oh, I'm predicting a break this week, too. No chapter next week. That's what I'm thinking is going to happen. What's the state of affairs downstairs? The cooks are currently partying at the banquet being held to commemorate the end of the culinary preparations. So they're having a party to celebrate, finish making all the food. We sealed off all the corridors on our way up here. If we lock this door up tight, no one should be able to make it up here for the time being. We've also placed the honor Denden Mushi to block radio transmission. Even the cooks are putting in a little work. The wedding hall is completely isolated. Good. Well done. Go change. Roger. Caesar. Get the mirror out. Knock, knock. Okay, so Caesar hopped out the mirror. Hiding Capone. Damn it, you oaf. Stop calling me that. So it does seem like Caesar's really changing his name. I like his look, too. So this is going to be your entrance into the tea party. Well, try to enjoy yourselves, scum of the earth. You're pretty scummy yourself, you know. Anyway, go hide the mirror somewhere over there quickly. Your job is to grab that mirror and fly into the hall. As soon as you hear Big Mom cry out in her strange voice, that thing is our one and only exit out of here. Try not to get any wild ideas. I'm not going to betray you now, of all the times. Yeah, Big Mom, she expecting that giant potion right about now. Caesar Clown? Ooh, the door noticed him. Oh no. Beige and the others are definitely planning something. Fucking door. Caesar noticed. Beige noticed. Rook Beige. Glare. Sheep. The fuck they gonna do about the door? Ooh. Chop the door. I whittle her down a notch or two. Loose lips sink ships. Ha. True. We've got about 30 minutes before the ceremony starts. Are the straw hats ready to go? Take a look for yourself. They're inside your own body. After all, aren't they? Oi, idiots. Snore. Sleep. Chopper. Nami sleep. Jinbei's up. Pedro's up. Carrot sleep. Yeah, everyone was asleep except Pedro and Jinbei. What the hell are you doing sleeping? What about the preparations? Let them rest. They have barely had the chance to sit down since they got here. I'll wake them 10 minutes before it all begins. Something's wrong with you lot. If you end up being a burden, I'll cut you all loose then and there. So it doesn't seem like you have plans on betraying them. Well, so far. Stop worrying. I will take care of the preparations and will also keep watch. Pedro's asleep. I thought he would have been out. Well, they were doing a lot of fighting since they got to this island, so. Those bastards. I'm actually shocked. Right? Get back in there. I walk into the hall myself. Get ready, you lot. After I step foot inside there, there's no going back. Hope you guys are ready for that break next week. Ninth floor bride in groom's room. I had no intentions of marrying when I arrived here, but the fact that I'm sitting here next to you is so strange. I almost feel as if I'm in a dream. Well, is that dream a good one or a bad one? She's using her charming. Sanji, so cute. Of course a good one. Really? I'm glad. I hope Sanji's not being swayed right now. Keep it together, Sanji. She's just acting. She's actually trying to kill me. Wait. Maybe I really was just dreaming. All the other stuff. No. Don't fall for it. Classic Sanji. Trust in your own memories. Sanji, what's wrong? Nothing. Our big kiss. If you don't want to in front of everyone and all, I'll be okay with kissing you on your forehead or something, or somewhere else, you know what I mean. Kiss me on the mouth, silly. We're going to be husband and wife, aren't we? I imagine this is how the real moment is going to be. Crash. Oi, what the hell was that noise? Lord Sanji crashed into the wall. The wall? He's bleeding like mad. Oh no, Sanji. So the outer pudding is crying and the inner pudding is mad as shit. The hell is with this pervert? I want to kill him right now. Ooh. Nice art, by the way. That split face. Alright, let's get this double page. Okay, so the Vince smokes. Enjoying Yanji eating whatever that circle thing is. Reiju sipping tea. One of the brothers. So this dog looking guy is showing I think Ichi something on a poster or a paper. Everyone's having a good old time. Sorry for a minute, I'm looking. Mother Caramel has her own seat. Dogtooth is chilling. Vince Smoke. The underworld guys. I expected this wedding to like have more big names. Because Beige did say like a lot of Big Mom's like territory companions are gonna be there. To see only the underworlds there, the underworld guys there, I expected a little bit more. Now then, friends and guesses, our main event. The 35th daughter of the Charlotte family, Sharding Pudding, and the third son of the Vince Smoke family, Vince Smoke Sanji, let the royal wedding begin. Like the guy in mask that he got on, the announcer. Oh, the pirate crew of the Yonko Big Mom and the armies of evil of the German 66. Beautiful. This young couple will connect the dreams of these two distantly families together. A marriage de raison. As these two are united as one. Once again, will the flowers of villainy bloom wildly across the land. Applaud the dizzying beauty of this day. The ceremony starts. There's no going back now. Applaud. That bastard, he's getting way too into this acting role. I was saying that. The blood-drenched wedding begins now. One Piece, next issue. We will be on a hiatus. It was coming. Everybody knew it was coming. It was coming. Right around the corner. That was a chapter. The wedding started. I expected, because of the title, I expected to at least, like, we get the ceremony words out of the way. You know, like, do you cherish and hold, blah, blah, blah. I expected we to get that part out of the way and, probably just get straight into the next chapter, probably get straight into the kids. Told you guys the break was coming. It was coming. So the okay chapter was okay. It was okay. I feel like this chapter was just one of those chapters to get to the point. Bro, it's kind of hard. This definitely could have been included in last week's chapter. Definitely could have been included in last week's chapter. Let me know what you guys think about the chapter. Let me know if you guys want me to do a review down in the comment section. Like the video if you did. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Hope I didn't bore you guys while doing this review. Again, thanks for watching. And I'll see you guys on the review if you guys want it. Later.